With winter comes the threat of icy roads. Ice can turn highways deadly. Plowing and salting are not making it disappear, but new technology is promising to. Chris Tuan and engineers at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln are making a new kind of road, one that melts ice.
We threw snow on this about an hour ago. You can see the bottom of the snow has melted, and there's no ice patches.
It's called conductive concrete. It heats up when plugged into a power outlet.
You can plug in a household socket, which is 110 volt AC power, and it will heat up the concrete.
What's inside makes it different from ordinary concrete.
These are the ingredients we use in the conductive concrete mix design. These are the steel fibers. They range from half an inch long to 1 inch long. This is the carbon powder.
It contains a mix of electrically conductive materials. It's poured into a concrete slab that's embedded with electrodes. When plugged in, they send electricity through the slab, generating heat.
Once we cast the conductive concrete, we stick this thermocouple wire to the center of the test slab to measure the temperature of the test slab.
Today, they're testing the heating performance of different conductive mixes.
The freezer is at a 25 degree temperature, and the test slab is hooked up to a 110 volt AC power, and we're going to dump some snow on the test slab.
They think they found a mix that can de-ice roads.
You can tell they just started melting.
They're testing it here in Lincoln, Nebraska. This bridge is made of 52 conductive concrete slabs. Each has its own electrodes connected to a power source.
This is the control room, and these are the relays and the power hookup. And here is the controller. Basically, it controls the power on and off functions.
The bridge turns on when the temperature turns down.
If the temperature of a slab is higher than 55 degrees, the power shuts off automatically. And if the temperature drops below 35 degrees, the power will kick back on.
It can also be turned on remotely to catch big snowstorms.
Basically, these two are the control buttons. You dial up, you turn it on, and let the bridge do its thing. And then when you think a snowstorm is over, just hit the stop button, turn the power off.
It takes 6 to 8 hours to warm to a toasty temperature that prevents ice.
When the panels are powered, you can put both hands on the conductive concrete without getting shocked. And the highest temperature it will run is only 50 degrees Fahrenheit, and it won't burn your fingers or anything. So it's absolutely safe.
The electric power running through this bridge could run 23 hair dryers. The team's been eagerly monitoring its performance in rough weather.
This year we got three snowstorms. Two of them had more than a foot, and the conductive concrete has been working very well. When the snowflakes touch the deck, it melts instantly.
They're also keeping tabs on the bridge's electricity bill.
They cost about $200 a snowstorm. So compared to the other de-icing technologies, it may have the potential to become the most cost-effective de-icing technology.
It's not cheap to build these roads, but once the conductive concrete is poured, it needs little maintenance. Lab tests show it's almost twice as strong as regular concrete, and its overall benefit is priceless. 10 to 15% of all roadway accidents are related to bad weather.
Using this technology, you would avoid all the icy bridges, so that would potentially save lives. The application is not just limited to the highway bridge applications. You can implement this technology for the sidewalks and driveways, because a lot of people during winter, they slip and fall and cause injuries.
They'll spend a couple more winters gathering data, and if it works, conductive concrete could not only provide safe travel, it may relieve us from the back-breaking shovel.
course, it may be some time until all roads, sidewalks and driveways are made of conductive concrete. In the meantime, we still need snowplows. And even snowplow drivers have embraced the latest technology. We'll take a ride in a virtual snowplow.